In 2021, exotic Caulerpa seaweed was discovered at Great Barrier Island in the Hauraki Gulf, and since then it's spread over a significant area. It's actually two very similar species. They're almost impossible to tell apart. Because they're exotic to New Zealand, there's a unique opportunity for them to take advantage of a space in the ecosystem that a native species isn't. And it grows in these long strands that spread out along the seafloor, forming large carpets across the seabed, which is excluding the organisms that would normally live in those locations. And that's what people are concerned about, this dramatic change to coastal ecosystems that's caused by this invader. These two exotic Caulerpa species are actually quite similar in appearance to our native species. There is some differences. This species has fine, flat leaves or blades, whereas most of the native species either have round beads or spiky leaves, which look a bit like rimu fronds. The native one doesn't spread in the same way because it's got creatures that keep it in check. Even the tiniest fragment, once it gets back on the seafloor, will grow out and form another mat and will just spread it into new areas.
At Great Barrier, we've got two zones of the controlled area notice, or CAN. The majority of the controlled area notice is offshore, outside of Port Fitzroy, and that is no anchoring unless you've got a permit, and there's no disturbance of seafloor fishing techniques. You can, however, drift fish without anchoring. The Waiheke CAN is similar to the anchoring zone on Aotea or Great Barrier Island. You are allowed to anchor, but we just need to make you aware that there is Caulerpa in the area. The safest thing to do if you do bring any weed up on your anchor is to treat it as suspicious and bag it and bin it.